Hello.
What's up, Tom?
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, hello.
Sorry. Tom, since last December, obviously the personnel has changed a little bit for you guys offensively, but I imagine the core beliefs have not changed. Even still, how has the offense changed since that game a year ago?
Yeah, I don't know that it's like you said. I don't know that it's changed philosophically too much. I think we're having to manufacture our yards in different ways. I think, you know, leaning on the offensive line and Carlos Hyde as we did last year and the year prior to that is not the best way to do it right now, as the young offensive line continues to grow and our young tailbacks continue to grow. So, you know, I think we're certainly capable of scoring the points and making the yards that we need to. They're just, like you said, it's just different. I don't know the best way to say it. Maybe a little bit more short and intermediate pass game on first and second down, a little more perimeter runs. But again, like you said, the core beliefs of spreading the field horizontally and vertically and playing most of the game in 11 personnel, you know, with one tight end and one tailback, I think that's always going to be the case around here.
I know you're not going to criticize the schedule because it is what it is, but this is the game everyone's pointed to. How much of a mystery are you guys, is your team to yourself heading into this game?
I think we found out a lot about ourselves from a toughness and mentality standpoint in Happy Valley a couple weeks ago. That was encouraging. We didn't play very good. A lot of the young guys played like young guys in a big time atmosphere. And like I said, I think I answered the question Saturday night, but it bears repeating. Had you asked me to sign up for that and that type of outcome prior to the game, I would have said, heck no. That I wanted to win a lot differently than that, but I think in retrospect, having won the game the way that we did, knowing that we played very poorly against a really good defense in one of the most hostile environments in all of college football with every ounce of momentum on their side, really showed a lot to us as a coaching staff about what kind of kids we're coaching, but I think showed a lot of themselves and what they can accomplish when their backs are against the wall. So that part we know a lot about. You know, we'll find out about the execution and the, you know, we gotta, obviously we can't play the way that we played in Happy Valley and expect to win this week. So we've gotta execute a lot better than we did in that game. And I think with that boost of confidence that we gained in that game, that we'll be able to do that.
Tom, we all know how JT has played so far. It's against this defense, will he have to make any more difficult throws?
Yes and no. We're certainly not going to ask him to be superhuman because he's not. But their defense does require you. I mean, they contest most every ball. You know, it's well documented, the press quarters coverage that they play, where it's basically cover zero schematically once you get past about 5 to 8 yards. And so he'll be required to be a lot more accurate than he was on Saturday against Illinois. But in terms of, you know, got to throw at 70 yards or got to throw at 100 miles an hour or anything like that, you don't have to do that to beat these guys in the throw game. You got to be on time and you got to be accurate.
You were saying the other night how accurate he is when he's on, right?
Very much so, yeah, which was a little bit surprising Saturday that early in the game he had missed the throws that he missed. But, yeah, in my career as a quarterback coach, he's probably in the top 2 or 3 that I've coached in terms of accuracy.
And you said you'd get that figured out of why he did miss a couple. What'd you figure out?
I think because a lot of the throws were, not to get too scientific, but a lot of the throws were against a cover three look where there were more mid-range defenders, less deep defenders, and so he was trying to make sure that he had enough on the ball to get it over the mid-range defenders and really was kind of not really throwing to a guy, just trying to make sure he muscled the ball over the mid-range defenders, and he wound up overthrowing about three passes. And so I think he just needed to trust the trajectory of his throw a little bit better.
Tom, if you guys won more than you've lost against that cover zero this year?
Yes. Yeah. Obviously, well, I mean, game by game, yes. snap by snap, maybe not, because I don't know. We saw it. 75 snaps of it in week two. So, and it's a much different front and style. I don't want to make, you know, the pressure bear cover zero is much different than 4-3 press quarters. It's a lot different.
And you guys are going to see that 4-3 look. You know that's what Michigan State does, but they've also had an extra week to get ready for you. Is there, and you guys have faced that multiple times this year, where you're playing a team that's had 2 weeks. Is there anxiety, is there angst with you before a game to say, get out there to the first snaps and say, okay, this is the surprise and here's how we got to deal with it?
On a normal, against another opponent maybe, but not against these guys. I mean, they have earned my respect because they are so good at what they do defensively, because they do the same thing over and over and over and over again. And they say, this is what we do. We're going to recruit and develop to this system. We're going to play this coverage and mix in this pressure with this coverage. And that's what we do. And you guys have to do it better than we do it. And, you know, it's very similar when I was at Iowa State 5-6 years ago when Iowa was so really good on defense. They just, I mean, they played 4-3 cover six every snap. I mean, every snap. And they just said, We know the weaknesses, we know the strengths, we know the adjustments, we know you're not going to trick us with formations, you're not going to trick us with motions, you're not going to, and Michigan State's the same way. You know, they know how to line up, they play the same defense for the most part, snap after snap after snap, and then they mix in, you know, about 25-30% pressure to keep you on your toes, and that's it.
Or when they do that, aren't they essentially saying, our X's are better than your O's?
Maybe not our X's are better than your O's. Maybe our X's combined with the skills and training that they have in that defense and where to be, when to be there, how to be there, against what play, they're saying that, but not necessarily mano-a-mano, my guy's better than your guy.